Hello and welcome. Have you ever wanted to drink like a sophisticated pirate? Or break free of your programming and finally gain some free will? Well, do I have a game and a drink for you? Detroit Become Human was developed by Quantic Dream and released in 2018. It's one of those movie-style games with QuickTime events and dialogue decisions that can result in multiple paths, all having different outcomes for the end of each chapter, as well as the game as a whole. Think classic choose-your-own-adventure books that you would get in the library. If you have played anything from Quantic Dream before, you know exactly what to expect with the graphics as well as the gameplay. It has similar gameplay styles to the Telltale games, so if you play them or have enjoyed them before, you're going to be right at home here. The cocktail we'll be crafting today is a play on a New York sour, which of course is a variation of a traditional sour, which was basically invented to stop pirates from getting scurvy. I sadly have to report that this is not a good port. First thing that's quite strange about the port, though, is the first time I played through this, a couple months ago, not a single issue. Game ran perfectly fine, I had one glitch at the end of the game that I googled, figured a way around it. 6 months later, boot the game back up, and now there is a crazy glitch that basically I could either get 2 hours of gameplay, or maybe 15 minutes, before it would crash out and land me on the desktop. Doing a ton of Googling, I quickly found out that this game just isn't very well optimized, and even running at lower settings, you'll still get this lockup where the entire game crashes. The only easy workaround that I figured out was to delete the shader cache files, but then you would have to wait for it to recompile, taking anywhere from like 5 to 15 minutes, and then reload it again, hoping that you could get farther. Now, I was able to actually finish the game and push my way through this, but it was extremely frustrating. Although, in the game's defense, apparently this is not the same issue on an AMD graphics card. But let's talk about the story. You follow three playable characters: Kara, a housekeeper, Marcus, a caretaker for an elderly artist, or Connor, a police investigator of Deviance. Deviance is what they call the AI when they gain free will, which ironically is kind of treated like a virus. You pass it from robot to robot. It's kind of strange, but funny. The music is quite beautiful, and it really sinks you into the moment and the experience. Speaking of experience, you won't need much experience to craft this cocktail. It seems kind of like a complicated cocktail, but once you get the trick of cracking an egg and rocking it back and forth, you will have no problem with this sour. So basically, you're going to start with 2 ounces of vodka, 1 ounce of lime juice, and then one egg white. Now, I've made some red wine simple syrup ahead of time, basically exactly what it sounds like. Red wine, sugar, boil, done. And we're just gonna pour this right on top as soon as we finish the cocktail. Although for me, what really shined in the game were the detective moments. I do love a good detective game, so this one really spoke to me in these moments. Walking through these fictional crime scenes and reconstructing all of the events that took place through the AI brain is such an interesting thing to behold. It definitely stole a lot from Batman Arkham Origins in the detective mode there, but it does really make sense for the character and works quite well. And in these moments, the most interesting, risky decision the game makes is allowing you to miss them. You can miss actual suspects that change the information you have going into the next situation, and you'll quickly find out when you are lost in the shuffle of things, because all of a sudden the game is half over and now you're realizing that you have missed multiple key pieces of evidence throughout all of these crime scenes. It plays almost like a futuristic Law and Order game when it comes to the Connor sections. The Marcus sections were a close second, because not only were you allowed to watch this character grow from obedient AI to radical thinker to leader of a movement, as well as letting you kind of plot your character's choice. Do you kill? Do you not kill? Do you steal? Do you not steal? Allowing you to have the moral values that you choose to instill in your character. With, of course, the caveat that sometimes the game will make you do what it wants you to do because it needs to get from point A to point B. And it is a very compelling story, in my opinion, when it comes to Marcus, if completely ham-fisted and over the top at many moments. Personally, for me, Kara is when the game really slows to a grinding halt. These are the moments where it feels like you are so railroaded to a specific outcome that you lose a little bit of agency, and quite frankly just made me not want to play the Kara sections. Personally, I find Connor to be my absolute favorite when it comes to characters in this game. The story is the real main event of this game. Everything lends itself to the story. The gameplay decisions, to the story. What you do or don't do in levels adds itself to the story. And for that, the story's good. It's not great, but I think a lot of that has to do with the multiple choices and multiple outcomes, so it's hard to get a direct path. Although there is something really interesting to be said about a game where an entire group of people can play it and have different experiences enough that they can discuss it and have totally different outcomes. Although the real issue with the writing, in my opinion, comes through its ham-fisted metaphors, as well as how it approaches these subjects as it mirrors historic events instead of reimagining them. I like to compare it to the Tim Burton Planet of the Apes versus Rise of the Planet of the Apes. Both fun movies, but one actually takes a subject and gives it a different perspective and allows you to see something that you might not have. Like, for example, when you spark the revolution, you begin by sneaking into a building, and you walk by a beautiful set piece, but it boldly screams the word RISE right into your eyeballs. I mean, it makes great trailer footage, but it's a little on the nose, don't you think? I like to work for my metaphors. When talking about dialogue choices for your playable character to do, they usually only give you one word, which generally is an experience or a feeling that will give you a hint at what your character will say, which can quickly take your player character's agency completely away from you when you kind of wanted to interact with the situation in a certain way, and when you chose what you thought was going to be the best way to interact with that, everything goes haywire. During this one set piece, you can break in with a gun and take hostages or shoot people, or you can try to trick your way in. I wanted to do a pacifist approach, so I tried to trick my way in. And the moment I approached the table, they just kept asking me why I was there, and then began to shoot at us. But I have to say, some dialogue instances are super intense and super interesting, where you have to balance out the stress level of the person you're interrogating, or you have a certain time frame because something is going on, or you just have to play this kind of puzzle game in dialogue choices to be able to unlock the appropriate dialogue choice for an outcome that you're looking for. Something else you might be looking for is the recipe to this delicious cocktail, so let's get it going. Alright, so to craft this cocktail, as always, we're going to start with some ice and pop it into our Boston shaker tin. Now, we are going to add 1 ounce of our lime juice to give it a nice little tart sweetness. I find the tart will help offset all the sweetness that we're about to put into this cocktail. 2 ounces of vodka. Any kind of vodka will work. I'm not really much of a snob when it comes to vodka, but I can enjoy a nice good vodka. Now we're going to take our egg, crack it, rock it back and forth, get all that egg white out, get rid of the rest. So take that shaker, slap it shut, and give it a hearty shake. This one's going to be a reverse dry shake, which means we are going to shake it one more time without ice. Take our Boston shaker, separate it. Sometimes slapping on the side will help. We're going to put our Hawthorne strainer on top, pour that bad boy back into our Boston glass. Then we're going to dump out all our ice and then give it a nice hearty dry shake. Dry shake always gives it nice tight bubbles, which I find just a better look. So once that is shaken, you're going to take that out. You're going to take your Hawthorne strainer and begin pouring it into the glass. Depending on the size of your glass, you might need to save some. You might just pour it all in. Now we're just going to take 1 ounce of our red wine simple syrup, which is just 50% red wine, 50% sugar, and we're just going to pour that right in. And as you can see, the density of that red wine simple syrup is going to sink to the bottom, allowing the egg white and vodka and lime juice to kind of intermix with all of it in the middle. And I just think it's a beautiful look, and it's just a great cocktail. I really hope you enjoy this one. So, if you're playing this on PlayStation, or you're just lucky enough that your PC didn't run into any of the problems my PC ran into, there's a good game here. Great concept, great characters. They just don't do much with it. They don't really change anything. They just mirror events that we already all know, which is interesting, but again, I would have liked to seen them do something different. That said, the game has a lot of redeeming qualities. Whether it's investigating crime scenes, whether it's interrogating witnesses, or just really enjoying the idea that your gameplay and game path will be completely different than someone else's, and you might have completely different endings by the end of the game, does provide something interesting, doesn't it? Well, as for this cocktail, I think I'm about calling it Detroit Sour. If you like that name, let me know in the comments. If you got a better name, definitely let me know in the comments. Well, I love this cocktail. It is a little sweet, but I've been told I'm a bitter person. So if you like this cocktail, let me know. And if you happen to be playing this game while drinking the cocktail, enjoy. Please like, comment, subscribe. Hope you're having a great day, and as always, hope to see you around real soon.